introduction to one-to-one correspondence. Hello friends, I am the parrot. Welcome to this chapter. Let's see what you will learn in this lesson. What are pairs of objects? And how to make a pair of two identical objects?
Toto needs to arrange his clothes in his almirah.
To do this, he has kept all his clothes on his bed. His mother comes to his room.
Oh wow, Chotu! All these socks are very beautiful. Which one of these pair would you wear for your first cricket class tomorrow?
What does a pair mean?
Let me explain to you. Tell me, how many hands do we have?
Two.
Yes. And how many legs?
Two.
Absolutely correct, Chotu. This means we have a pair of hands. And similarly, we also have a pair of legs.
Okay. So this way we have a pair of eyes as well. Right, Mom?
Yes, son. You got it right.
Mom, what does a pair of socks means?
We have two legs. And we wear one sock on each leg. On both feet, we wear identical socks. Such as these two socks with stars, isn't it?
Yes.
Because we wear these two socks with stars together on each leg. And that is how they form a pair of socks. This means a group of two identical objects is called a pair.
Oh, okay.
Can you tell me another example of a pair?
The pair of earrings you're wearing.
Right, Chotu, you're absolutely correct. Both of my earrings look alike. And I wear them together in each of my ears. So these two are also in a pair. Do you know what this process of making pair is called?
No.
This process of making pairs is called one-to-one correspondence. Come on now, quickly keep all these clothes inside and go to sleep.
So children, like Chotu, can you think of more examples of pairs? That's all for today. In this video, we learned what are pairs of objects, how to make pair of two identical objects, and the process of making pairs of objects is called one-to-one correspondence. In the next video, we will see some more examples of one-to-one correspondence. Till then, bye friends.